Hi, welcome back to our lecture on farm tools. This time, we'll begin our class with a short video clip introducing ancient Chinese farm tools. While watching, find out which specific tools are mentioned in it and which farming process they belong to. Here comes the video.
One of the big challenges in farming is that certain crops ripen unevenly, like wheat, barley, and rice. That means you have to harvest them selectively, not en masse with a scythe or a sickle. That's why the ancient Chinese invented this clever bit of cutting-edge technology, the harvesting knife.
After the harvest came the threshing process. And here too, the Chinese proved to be unusually clever. You've heard of separating the wheat from the chaff? Well, for a long time, farmers used this, a winnowing basket. The idea was to catch the grain in the basket while letting the chaff go off by the wayside. But this process was labor-intensive and dreadfully inefficient.
That's why 2,200 years ago, the Chinese invented the so-called wind machine, or winnowing fan. I found this one at a village in southwest China.
So, which are the major farm tools discussed in the video? Yes, the harvesting knife, the winnowing basket, and the winnowing machine, or also called winnowing fan. Then, which farming processes are mentioned? Harvesting, threshing, and winnowing, as the name of these two tools suggest. Then, what tools are used in the threshing process? No idea? Don't worry, we'll find out the answer together in the later part of today's lecture. After our earlier discussion of the three farming stages from tilling to seeding and irrigating, today we'll move on to stage 4, 5, and 6, harvesting, threshing, and winnowing. In the video we watched earlier, have you noticed that the host actually mentioned two other harvesting tools besides the harvesting knife? That is, scythe and a sickle. Although minor differences exist among them, they all fall into the same category, sickle. One of the most popular multi-use tools that our ancestors used in agriculture. Primarily designed to do harvesting of crops, the sickle is also used for cutting weeds in the fields or cutting forage for feeding livestock. To modern people, a sickle is a handheld agricultural tool consisting of a curved metal blade attached to a short wooden handle. But as one of the most ancient harvesting tools, sickle has also evolved in a similar way as other farming tools. Initially of clay and stone, later bronze and iron. In primitive times, the clay sickle and the stone sickle were predominantly used. Later, during Shang and Zhou dynasties, bronze sickles came into being. The ones unearthed in Dayangzhou, Xingan, Jiangxi province are considered to be the oldest bronze harvesting tools. Then, since the Warring States period, iron sickles began to replace the earlier ones as the dominant harvesting tool until modern days. But due to the short handle attached to the sickles, it forces the user to harvest in a stooped or squatting position, which makes harvesting a slow, exhausting task. Thus, the appearance of another prominent harvesting tool during Song and the Yuan dynasty cannot be ignored, that is, push sickle. While using it, the farmer can stand while holding the much longer handle and push it forward against the top layer of the field. Despite the fact that push sickles were not as widely used as other more simplified sickles, its creation bridges traditional sickles and modern grain harvesting machines, thus a breakthrough in the development of harvesting tools. The mechanism applied in push sickles are further developed in later mechanical reapers, reaper binder, and then the combine harvester. After the grains are harvested, they need to be threshed in order to loosen the grains from the stalks. Remember the question posed in the beginning of our lecture? What tools are needed in the threshing process? Now, it's time to solve the mystery. Farmers may thresh the grains by striking them against a bucket with bare hands, or with some threshing tools such as flails. Another traditional method of threshing is to make donkeys or oxen pull a stone roller and walk in circles on the grain on a hard surface. Detached by the threshing tools, the knocked-off grains always had quite a few hulls, leaves, and other crumbs mixed in. In order to remove the impurities, farmers invented lots of winnowing tools, like dustpan and winnowing baskets. But the process of winnowing using these tools is too labor-intensive and dreadfully inefficient. So, another extraordinary invention serving this purpose is the winnowing machine, also called the winnower or grain winnower. Does it look familiar to you? Yes, because it's such a popular farm tool in rural families that some of us may even have used it in our childhood. Although being popular even in the late 20th century, the origin of the winnowing machine can date back to West Han Dynasty in 200 BC, more than 2200 years ago. Then, how does it work? Firstly, the crop is pulled into the bin on top. Then, turn the rotary-driven fan at a constant speed, which creates a steady wind. At the same time, let go a latch here, and the heavier grains will resist the wind and fall into a basket under the machine, while the lighter chaff or empty grains will get blown away by the wind out of the back of the machine. In this way, the edible grains are easily separated from the inedible chaff. What an amazing device! No wonder poets like Mei Yaocheng and Wang Anshi in Northern Song Dynasty both wrote poems in praise of the winnower. They all highlighted the good quality of a winnower, that it can effectively discard the jaws and keep the essence of grains, which echoes the quality of a person. As we can see, even daily things like a farm tool can be a source of inspiration for poets. So far, we've discussed six farming stages and a variety of farm tools used in each stage in this chapter. But before the grains become real food on the table, what other stages do crops go through? Which other type of farm tools did our ancestors use? Can you do some research and present them, their name, function, history, and cultural notes? After all this, I guess we've all been impressed by the long journey for grain seeds traveling from the birthplace, the dirt, to humans' food recipe. The alteration is so great that we cannot simply forget industrial farmers who have been contributing every single effort to the making of our livelihood. That's all. Thank you for watching.
锄禾日当午, 汗滴禾下土, 谁知盘中餐, 粒粒皆辛苦。